It is the last point of civilization before entering the exclusion zone.
The exclusion zone was initially a 19-mile radius set around Ground Zero, the nuclear reactor that exploded at Chernobyl in 1986. The zone remains off limits unless you're an employee or have a permit and an officially sanctioned guide. And where I'm going is even more tightly controlled. Now, roughly the size of Rhode Island, the zone contains much more than the Chernobyl nuclear complex. The scarred landscape is dotted with derelict villages, as well as the entire abandoned city of Pripyat, which sits frozen in time.
This is Lenin Avenue. So this is also referred to as the Road of Death because it leads into the city of Pripyat, the dead city. There are apartment blocks on the left and right, shops. There's a large promenade sidewalk that went down the city center. And now, for the most part, it's completely overgrown.
Once a vibrant modern city of 50,000 people, Pripyat's proximity to the nuclear power plant attracted the country's best and brightest scientists and engineers. It was paradise by Soviet standards. But on April 26, 1986, it all came crashing down when reactor number 4 exploded, releasing 400 times more radioactive material into the atmosphere than the atomic bomb that fell on Hiroshima. Pripyat and the surrounding area were evacuated within days of the blast, and the exclusion zone was established. Today, it sits a rusted shell of its former glory, a city reclaimed by nature. Heading southeast of town, my destination comes into view, the infamous Chernobyl power plant. And my mission to find out what really happened starts at nuclear reactor number 4, the source of the explosion. Even with reactor number 4 sealed off by a newly constructed $2 billion, 36,000-ton steel containment structure, life-threatening radiation lingers everywhere across the facility. And I'm about to enter this place where few outsiders would ever dare or be permitted to go.